Yes, I'm wearing a Chrome Hearts tank top. Yes, we get it. I wear it all the time. I've got multiple. I'm addicted to them. Cool. Now that that bit is done. Yo, what up, eh? How you doing, guys? My name is Sanchez. Today, we are back with another video. And as you can see from the title, we're throwing it back. It's been a long time since I've done a pickups video, especially such a hefty one. And truth be told, I just have not been shopping. Usually, you can at least expect to see a pickups video from me around the sort of winter sale, summer sale period. This time around, I barely even shopped even during those times. So, we're still in LA. There has been a change of plans, unfortunately. I was meant to go to Toronto, but that's not happening. I cancelled my trip to Canada, and hopefully, I will be able to make it out at some point later in the year. I'm flying back to London tomorrow. And so I figured I'd show you guys all the wonderful pieces that I got from the beautiful land of Los Angeles. So let's just get straight into it. We're gonna start from the bottom and then work our way up. And the first pair of trousers is actually a little shameless plug. I just wanted to quickly run it by you. If you follow me on Instagram, you guys would have seen these already. I've sort of worn them, teased them, never really spoke much about it, but I figured now I would take this opportunity to do so. And it is going to be our new reworked jeans drop. When this video is live, the jeans should be live. Links to it will be in the description box down below, so do go check it out if you wish. We took apart some old vintage Levi's jeans, the cut ranging from 501 to 505, so we wanted to keep it somewhat...
I'm not sure I understand.
Siri, come on, what are you doing? Go back to bed. We wanted to keep it somewhat slim, straight, but with the cut and sew action, it turned out to be a bit more slim, skinny, which is amazing anyway, because on this pair, they look absolutely incredible. Now, the colors aren't always as drastic and as contrasty as this, but we played around. Some of them are a bit more tonal, some of them are a bit more contrasty, like this one. And yeah, man, I'm super hyped. We took the two pieces on the exterior and flipped them inside out. So the pockets are unfortunately low-key useless, like it doesn't have any pockets. However, you can still use the pockets from the inside, if that makes sense. I'm gonna try to portray that in the B-roll right now. I just think it's so cool and unique. You also see the overlocked stitches and seams on the outside of the leg. Now, some of the jeans come in different lengths and we left that raw so you can have this separated effect, which I love. But yeah, man, quick little shameless plug. Reworn, there's about 12 pairs of jeans dropping, I believe. As usual, your support is very much appreciated. I don't have what many would call like a merch or whatever. So this is my way of putting something out there that I love and I'm fully behind, as opposed to just slapping something on a t-shirt. Not there's anything wrong with it, but that's just my take. Yeah. Yeah. So item number one, reworked jeans. Then item number two, the first sort of real vintage pickups of this video. And it's actually a pair of jeans that I've already showed you guys in my previous video, but I only briefly touched upon it. Loads of you guys were asking me about it. And those were the vintage Levi's flared denim jeans with a sort of painter effect. Now, unfortunately, so many of you guys asked me about the cut. There is no information regarding that. I wouldn't be able to tell you. It's got the orange label in the back. They're so beautiful, man. The cut is absolutely insane. Such a nice taper towards the knee, and then it just flares out to the bottom. When worn with boots, they look incredible. I love the sort of painted effect, the rips that can be found across the jeans. In fact, there's actually a pretty big one around the crotch area, which I'm gonna need to go get that repaired. But besides that, so fucking sick, man. I even love the sort of, what's it called? Released hem. So you can kind of see the fold that was present in the past, and now it's just been released, and it has this raw finishing towards the bottom as well. Love them. Got these jeans from the beautiful people over at Moth Food, who actually, I'm gonna include this clip now, who actually allowed me, Owen, Fernando, and his gang to go to the store and shop. It's based in LA, it's appointment only, and they have some incredible stuff. So I'm just gonna roll with the clip right now.
And this girl sort of snapped out.
Oh, that's why. Oh, yeah.
Oh, who's the girl, Jacob? Who's the girl, Jacob?
Oh, this girl got me Snapchatting.
Do you have any more? You got some of this.
No, do you have any more?
All right, what are your thoughts on that jumper?
Get a case of it. You need to get a case of it.
This is probably the softest jumper ever created.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna game in it, and I'm also gonna wear it.
Would you cop?
100% cop, but
it's a really nice t-shirt.
Put some music in front of this. Some London music.
Some London music?
Like a quick edit, ready? Make it slow-mo.
Okay, go.
Me for niggas and records. Yeah! It's
You know it's in slow motion, so you don't need to move in slow motion as well. This guy is such a... Content.
You gotta tilt the camera. Pow, yeah, I'm pow, you know, pow, yeah, I'm Lee from the beat. Pow, if you don't know about me, pow, better ask something quickly, cause pow, yeah. You walk forward and then you turn.
Yeah, now you can do it. Out comes the clout god. One of the dudes that's inside. Fernando Rangel in white jeans. So many blanks as well. Yeah, that shit fire. So sick, love the colours as well.
Hello mate.
Yeah, they're massive. What are you getting through these camo cargos?
Possibly, I like the Swiss camo style.
Aren't you wearing some? Oh no, you're wearing some regular stuff. Not bad at all, mate, not bad at all.
Yeah.
Damn.
Not bad, honestly. Nah. No, I can see in the arm. Nah. The body, no.
For you, you're a bit slimmer.
Nah, it'll look too cropped. My legs will look way too long.
She looky kind of fire still. chill. Just trying to get the back. Yeah, that's fine.
Oh yeah, you got the chat tee with the fucking flag.
Sam is just looking for the
thing. I wanted like a 32.
Okay. These.
It's dusty in here.
Oh, these.
It's dusty in here. It's bad. It's blue.
Okay. Alright. Yeah? Fire, oh my god. It's slurring us. Shit. Yo, those are your size.
Vintage.
This shirt looks so good. It's
fire. Yeah, this is red.
The jeans though. Nah, the jeans genuinely, I'm quite happy with
them. Wow.
They hit the shoe perfect.
Yeah,
you see how the pin lights. Say
Done. Cop, as long as he doesn't tax me too much.
Those are probably 3,000.
Blip!
Oh, that's going in for sure. Fucking jacked. Oh!
Wow, Sam, have you been hitting the gym?
Wow!
Fuck, this shirt's so nice as well. Yeah, it's too
small. Oh, wow.
It's alright, Fernando can get it.
That's
back though.
Southwest Bowling Supply.
Mm-hmm.
Bowling Supply.
Little bowl.
Alright, let's
live
go.
Unboxing.
Live unboxing. And here's what happens. Fernando gets something for $5 and then chucks it up for $110. And you're right.
This is personal.
Personal.
Oh, it's just a car.
Oh.
I mean, it's a sick car.
Whoa, that's unpaid.
Woo!
Wait, is that unpaid or is that bleach?
Yeah,
oh, wow.
Yo.
Damn. Throw it on.
That's
so sick. Fernando's like, I ain't touching that shit.
Drip.
Big drip.
Drip.
Yeah, that fade is actually kind of fire.
Yeah, thank you.
But yeah, that's that for Moth Foods. I found a few other pieces that I'm going to be showing you guys today. But number one, Moth Food. the jeans. Then we're moving to unsound rags territory, which if you guys aren't aware, is Fernando's vintage line. So Fernando's got Silver League, which is the more archival designer fashion, and then you've got Unsound Rag, which is a bit more vintage, super well curated. They've got their look, their style that they're going for, where the colors are fairly muted, the pieces are, you know, a nice amount of distressing to them, and they're blessed. Well, they haven't blessed me, I'm still paying for everything, but you know, we're getting a friends and family discount. Thank you. And the pair of trousers that I got from them are these beautiful leather, brown, very subtle flare trousers, leather trousers. I can't even speak. There is literally, I don't know what else you could say. They're so sick, like they fit incredibly well. Just like sit perfectly at the waist for me. I thought at first, I was like, oof, these are gonna be too small. But they sit amazingly, the length is perfect as well. Especially when I wear them with boots, you know, the heel just sticks out and it just sits really, really nicely on top of them. Like I said, they've got a very, very subtle flare, and that can be seen when wearing these with boots more so than, say, your loafers or a low silhouette shoe. I love them. They're heavy. A lot of leather pieces today, they feel super soft. They have been treated in so many ways that at times the leather can be so buttery, which isn't a bad thing at all. But every now and again, you do want your leather to be very, you know, durable and have that sort of strong feel to it. And these trousers definitely, definitely have that. I mean, look at that, man. The brown on these, so, so good. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Bro, this is gonna be a long ass video. Next up, we have the only piece that I purchased from Silver League, and those are these incredible, bro. I'm in love with this. These, sorry, pair of trousers from Yoshiyuki Konichi. Yes, from Yoshiyuki Konichi. Incredible, incredible piece. Now, if you follow me on my Instagram, you guys would have seen that a while back. I posted about me looking for this whole jumpsuit from Rick Owens from their Fall Winter 16 collection, I think I want to say. That's where it was from. You know, I really loved it, I wanted it. Now, supposedly the jumpsuit is super hard to get your hands on just because it's rare. They'd make some trousers, but the trousers didn't look as good, at least in my opinion. And then I came across these when I went to Fernando's house and I was like, bro, these are insane. And at first I genuinely thought they were the Rick. Turns out these are much older, and one might say that these might have been the inspiration for the Rick collection and some of the pieces that could be found, because the colors is oddly similar, for slash exactly the same. I love the cut, I love the super flowy nature of it. The material itself is super light, just perfect for a place like LA. Breathable, very lightweight, two pockets at either side, sort of cargo style, no other pockets besides that. Now this was a size 3, which is equivalent to a size large. It does fit a bit roomy, in fact very roomy, but the two toggles that can be found are definitely helpful for me to tighten that up. But that is that. I'm super gassed to have added this to my collection, and I'm curious as to how I'm gonna be wearing it back at home. Like in LA, it's easy because it's very hot here, so you can, you know, throw these on with my sneakers, with my Ricks, and I'm good to go. In London, when the weather can get hot, however it's cold for the most of the time, you know, it's gonna be interesting to see if I can pair it up with boots and how I'm gonna be able to get away with it. But that is going to conclude our trouser segment. Four trousers, we're now moving to the tops. Hopefully with the tops will be a lot quicker because there's less to be said, to be honest. Next up, we have t-shirts, and the first t-shirt that I picked up is actually from the Melrose Trading Post. Like, there isn't much to it, it's just a vintage tee. I love the cut, I love the fading. You've got the Batman logo that can be found at the front. In the back, I love it, it just says the Bat, the Cat, the Penguin, and then you've got a super faded Warner Bros. Logo, single stitch, distressing all over, especially around the armpit section. I don't know what happened here or why that is, but yeah, very prominent there. Holds throughout the piece. This coloration, the fit, everything about it is perfect. And I got it for a very cheap price. I can't remember exactly how cheap, but it was a steal, and I'm so happy to add this to the collection. Another t-shirt, this time from the Unsound Rags once again. This one is actually a t-shirt that you guys would have seen, especially in my previous video. It says Real Men. Now, I can actually read it out. I'm gonna hopefully whiz through it very quickly. But it says, Real men cry, shop, dance, gossip, see dirt, eat quiche, 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 Cook meals, clean floors, listen to women, don't bully others, do laundry properly, acknowledge feelings, don't need pornography, can laugh at themselves, admit to making mistakes, supports a woman's choice, get scared and admit to it, love and care for children, aren't afraid of differences, not need a gun to feel real, speak out against sexual violence, know their penises are not their brains, don't want war, violence, hate and greed, need to love others and want others to love them. Oh yes, vote for, contribute to and help elect women. I mean, bruh, what a t-shirt. Genuinely, Fernando, I have no idea where the f*** you found this tee. It's printed on a Hanes Beefy tee, size large, double stitch. But you know, every now and again, it's a little double stitch t-shirt can infiltrate and it looks great, so I'm happy with it. It looks awesome. There you go. Job all done. Boom, on sound rags. Like I mentioned before, links to everything will be in the description box down below. Now, next up, we have quite possibly my favorite t-shirt pick of this trip, and it's this incredible t-shirt from Moth Food. Now, this one says, Evergreen Park Fizz Ed. And there is a name that has been just like, it's hard to see. Pretty sure it says star, as in S-T-A-H-R in across the band. Distressed, double layered, green on white. The cut is just so good. Like, it reminds me of one of those old t-shirts that a boxer might have worn and trained in, you know? Like, I'm thinking of like some old Muhammad Ali footage where he's wearing a t-shirt and they're usually quite short in the body. The sleeves hit really nicely, and because they're wham and they've got muscles, it looks sick. So that's what I thought about when I saw this piece. It's heavily distressed, but you know, it doesn't look f***ed up, or like way too f***ed up anyway. But again, that's super subjective. I'm sure someone will look at this and think, bro, what are you talking about? That is a very f***ed up t-shirt. I love the colors. Moth Foods absolutely killed it. They've repaired some seams whenever they could, but they left some holes left open. Double t-shirt already? Yeah, so you've got the green on the outside and a white tee on the inside. Yeah, boom. Moth Foods. Next up, once again, from Moth Foods, the only shirt that I got from this trip, it's this beautiful yellow number, which you guys have seen already. This is the last piece I'm gonna say that about, actually, which you guys have seen in my previous video when I wore it for the look numero dos. You all will be showing right now. It's just a yellow Fruit of the Loom t-shirt with this emblem logo that can be found on the breast pocket. Beautiful, it's like this mustard yellow, size XL. It fits, you know, like an XL would, I guess, like a slim XL though, to be honest with you. I love it, it's light, it's mustard. I've said mustard already about three times. It kind of gives me sort of, what's his name, Cliff Booth? Yeah, Cliff Booth, is that his name? From Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, Brad Pitt's character. Kind of gives me that vibe, especially when worn in that outfit with all the colors, the blues, the yellows. I think it's sick, and it's definitely a shirt that I can see him wearing. I can get my 70s on. It can look amazing with blue denim. It's also gonna look amazing with the brown leather trousers and with whatever else I wanna add to the bottoms. So that is why I picked up this piece. Super versatile, it looks great. What's not to love about it? Then we're moving on to hoodies and sweatshirts, and hoodie numero uno is this number from Unsound Rags, Carhartt. Now, me and Fernando were talking about how old this piece might be, and we think, based on the logo, it's anywhere between the 90s or potentially even the 80s. Now, don't quote me on this. In fact, if I can find the proper information for it, I will plaster it on the screen right now. But I love this piece, man. It fits huge. Well, no, it doesn't fit huge. It's a size, what's the size? It must be an XL. Yeah, it's a size extra large. It fits really big. I love, love, love the fading that can be found across the piece. It's this really nice sun faded look, which is actually something that I believe Unsound Rag does the best. Like, some of their sun faded pieces, the way they curate those items, and I don't, God knows where they find them, but they look insane. And yeah, I'm gonna add this to the collection. Lovely little hoodie, lovely color. Got a tiny bit of branding, which actually gives it a throwback vibe anyway. I love the two little toggles that can be found on the hood itself. I was thinking of actually cutting some of the hood, just kind of have a straight line going down the middle, have a bit more breathing room, and I think would actually add to the piece, in my opinion. Boom skis, that is that for the Carhartt hoodie. Lovely, Unsound Rags. Killed it. And then the final piece, well no, the final sweatshirt, once again from Unsound Rags. Bruh, how many times am I gonna say that? Time out. If you guys follow me on my Instagram, you guys would see this piece. It's beautiful. Absolutely stunning piece. Crew neck, sweatshirts with an incredible cut and design and fading. It really, really reminds me of my undercover jumper, which is the reason why I gravitated towards this piece, but in a vintage form, you know? There's some really nice, authentic distressing that can be found throughout the body, like especially around the main body area. The material is softened so much now. I don't know if that's through wear or through, I'm pretty sure it's through wear and wash. Someone might have just gone ham with the sandpaper as well, who knows? These things can be recreated, although I feel like you can tell when it's authentic and through wear. On the sleeves, you can see some of the holes that can be found. It's just so good on the elbows as well. And I love the various sort of colors that can be found throughout the garment. So the body is sort of a light green. Then once you get to the sleeve, it sort of darkens. And then when you get to the cuffs, it's another shade of a light green. It's so fire, man, especially with the prints that can be found in the middle that's super faded. This is one of my favorite pieces that I purchased from this whole trip. I think it's incredible and one that I'm gonna hopefully cherish for a very long time. And that's the thing with vintage, man. Like, in one way, shape, or form, like I was talking to a store owner, in fact, one of the stores that I'm gonna be showing you guys in a second, and we spoke about how, you know, so sometimes with vintage garments, like, I just want to look at them. I don't even want to wear them. I sort of want them hanging, almost like a piece of art, which is cool. Obviously, at the end of the day, clothes serves a purpose to clothe us, obviously. So wearing them is kind of, bruh, where am I going at this point? I basically love clothing, mate. And some of these vintage pieces are fuego.
The behind the scenes.
How we do?
Quick, bro.
How we do?
Ty's off to do some deliveries.
Shipping is an essential food and business.
This is really crazy. Yeah. We got made and measure and shit. Francis at the site. Rashawn editing SL. I'm editing SL. It looks crazy.
Good shit, bro. And then we got this man's over here doing some some booky ass filming by his bed.
It's temporary.
Then we're moving on to final two pieces, and they're both outerwear and piece numero uno to close off all the unsound rags. Fernando, you better be cutting that check for this plug. Bruh! Carhartt, literally, like, distressed. I don't want to say torn because it isn't really, but like, it's just so good. One thing that I love about Carhartt jackets, especially the vintage ones, is the cut. Especially when they don't have the elasticated waistband that can often be found at the bottom of them. I think they fit. You've got the corduroy collar, which in this case has just been worn in perfectly. Like, some of it is pretty much gone. On others, the ridges are a bit more prominent. The collar, super nice and faded. You've got this really nice little logo that can be found on the left chest. The two pockets at either side have been heavily distressed. It's got a zip enclosure, but also has these sort of Velcro closure. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the Carhartt jacket. I wish I could give you guys the cuts of them or like the exact name of them. I don't have it and I don't know it, but I will ask Fernando and hopefully he'll be able to shed more light with regards to it. Beautiful piece, man. So, once again, so happy to add to my collection. Last, but certainly not the least, I had to hit up my favorite vintage or slash just favorite store in LA, and that is Vintage on Hollywood, which can be found on Sunset. This store is so good. Like, I've sung about it plenty of times on this channel, and I came across this jacket. Boom! Satin varsity jacket from Mikey Boy. Now, where do I start? The color, the shape, the condition, everything about it is stunning. It's a black satin, which when the light hits it sometimes, especially when it's sunny, it can come across as brown. Love that. Now, I don't know if that's due to the age or what it is, but I love that. Then you have the mixture of this sort of cream and red colors that can be found throughout, both on the shoulder details and also on the collar and also on the cuffs, the ribs. Bro, this piece is so f***ing fire. Mikey. Mike, you killed it. You were a champion of something from the 1957s. the Trinity champion. We love to see it. And in the back, it says Trinity written in this beautiful font. And what's it called? Chain stitched, I think. That's what it's called, right? Chain stitched. It fits incredibly well. Vintage on Hollywood, once again, smashed it. I tip my hat off to you. As in my opinion, one of my favorite stores out in LA. Their selection is just stunning. But that, ladies and gentlemen, is going to wrap up this video. Those were my pickups, my vintage pickups. If you're hearing some noise outside, I'm terribly sorry. They seem to be doing some work and I can't control that, unfortunately. But that is that for this video. I'm so hyped to add these to the collection, bring them back to London, wear them with my other pieces. Probably gonna be doing like a, you know, trying to follow my one in, one out rule. So I'm gonna be selling some pieces. And yeah, man, that's what keeps the fashion ball moving. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a thumbs up because it helps me out tremendously. If you wish to follow me on my social media, it's all right here in this corner. S-A-N-G-I-E-V. That is it from me. Have a beautiful day. Take care. Before that, rework jeans. Link in the description box down below. It's live. And by the time you finished watching this video, I mean, if it sells out by the end of this video, that's a beauty. That's a very big thing. Thank you. Speaking of selling out, I forgot. Yo, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. The second collaborative piece that I did with Harry Hunt & Co. has officially sold out. It took, I mean, ideally, I'd love to say 48 hours, but there were two chains that sort of, you know, pushed it over 48 hours. But we're gonna say the weekend because it went live on Friday. It was sold on like Sunday late night type stuff. So a little over 48 hours. But thank you, thank you, thank you so much, man. That is absolutely insane to me. Both the single pendant and the pearls. So I am hyped for you guys to get that. Hopefully, as I said, you guys will love it just as much as we did making it and just as much as I love wearing it. So, so thankful. So thank you. That is that. That is officially my goodbye. Have a beautiful day. Take care.
I'm sorry.
What? What?